I was in need of a digital microscope which would let me capture videos with a decent quality for a reasonable price, so I built this thing right here. Thanks to the Raspberry Pi Zero W, it directly outputs an HDMI video signal with next to no latency, but it also lets you save the files to an USB stick, or in this case an SD card. It would be easy to configure it to stream over Wi-Fi or do other cool things. It uses a Raspberry Pi camera module together with a cheap smartphone macro lens. This also makes it easy to use any other lens and adapt the microscope to the task you want to use it for. Although I have used some aluminum parts, most of the microscope can be 3D printed and assembled without any special tools. Considering the price, the video quality is very good, especially in the center of the image. It gets a little bit blurry on the outside and the depth of field is also quite shallow, but this could be improved by using a better lens. Still, it is a great tool to check your electronics or have a closer look on your 3D prints to spot any problems. It also lets you inspect your tools. Not that this defect was especially hard to see, but you get the idea. And overall, it's just really cool to have a closer look on the things in your shop. I mean, look how cool this felt looks. Even simple foam looks amazing in my opinion. The assembly is fairly straightforward. You can find all the parts needed on Hackaday, the link is in the description. I used aluminum for the base, but you could also 3D print it. However, you want to make it as heavy as possible, so maybe add some pieces of steel or similar. A 12mm steel rod gets clamped to the base with a M4 grub screw. The screw dimensions aren't critical, so use whatever you have at hand. The main body of the microscope is clamped onto the steel rod with an M4 screw. To be able to move the microscope head up and down, I'm using a rack and pinion design. For this, you need a 5mm shaft. I went with aluminum because it's easily machinable. I added a flat spot, so the set screw for the gear is going to have a better grip, however this isn't absolutely necessary. The knob could also be 3D printed and then glued onto the shaft. The gear comes with a hole, which needs to be tapped first. It then gets clamped with an M3 grub screw. And that's it for the base assembly. Next up is the microscope head. The 6 holes of the main part with the rack on the back needs to be tapped for M3 screws. Then place the spacers on it and mount the Raspberry Pi Zero W. Next up, the camera module. This one is version 1.3 and comes with a flex cable, which directly mounts into the Pi. Now screw in the camera holder and push the camera into it. This piece can be modified easily to allow other camera sizes or lens types. I would not recommend to press the camera sensor all the way in, as this makes removing it a bit harder. The lens I'm using is a 20x macro lens and it comes with this white clip. The offers for those come and go, so I'm not going to post any links, but I'm sure you can find it on the usual websites. As I said, it's easy to modify the camera head to mount any other lens, so you don't have to use this one. Lastly, add a button on the two lowest pins of the Raspberry Pi and push in an SD card, preferably with Raspbian OS installed. Insert the microscope head into the base and the assembly is finished. In order to get a video signal right after startup, we need to add some code. For that, I'm assuming that your Pi is running the newest version of Raspbian and you are already connected to it via SSH. There are tons of tutorials out there how to do that, so I'm not going into detail here. First, we need to activate the camera, so type in sudo raspi-config. hit enter, and then go to the interface options, camera, and hit yes. That's all we have to do here, so move to finish and decline the reboot, we will do that later. Next, we create the script to auto-start the camera. So enter sudo nano camera.sh and paste the code I'm providing. Press Ctrl and O to save and Ctrl and X to exit. Then we add another script which will let us shut down the Pi safely, so type in sudo nano shutdown.py and again just paste the code, save it and exit. We have to do this one more time, type in sudo nano /etc/rc.local and paste the code. This is going to run both of our scripts right after startup. Save and exit, and we are finished. Reboot the Pi by entering sudo reboot, and after a few seconds you should be able to see the video feed. Assuming you connected a display, of course. Make sure your shutdown button is doing what it should do. The green LED should turn off some seconds after you've pressed it. And that's it. Thanks for watching and have a great day.